We don't think much of the change in our pocket now. But in the time of Jesus, a pious Jew would hate the idea of even touching a Roman coin. Why? That's the subject of today's hidden treasure. You see, the Jews were forbidden to make carved images of human beings. But right in the time of Jesus, Tiberius, the Roman emperor, started minting a coin that became one of the most offensive symbols for the Jews. Let's take a closer look at it together. Firstly, it included a clear carved image of the emperor. In addition to that, right around the head, it included an inscription that stated, Augustus Tiberius, son of the divine Augustus. On the other side, it continued, High Priest. So, here we see a coin that stated that Tiberius, the Roman emperor, was the son of a god and the high priest. To the Jews, the Romans could not have made a more offensive object if they had tried. So it is easy to see why a pious Jew would not want to carry this kind of coin in his pocket. This gives us a better understanding of what is happening in Mark 12, when the Pharisees and Sadducees try to trap Jesus again, asking, "Is it lawful to pay taxes to Caesar or not?" They were sure they had Jesus trapped. He would either support taxes to Caesar, angering the crowd, or by denouncing taxes, he would be found guilty by the Romans of a capital charge. The response of Jesus is simply amazing. "Why do you test me? Bring me a denarius that I may see it." The coin with the carved image of the emperor and the offensive inscriptions was brought to Jesus. And he replied, "Give to Caesar the things that are Caesar's, and to God the things that are God's." So the coin bears Caesar's image. Therefore it belongs to him. But what bears God's image? In Genesis 1:27, we read that we were created in God's image. The point of Jesus is clear. That coin was made by Caesar, belonged to him, and existed to glorify him. So give it back to him. God, on the other hand, created something far more valuable and precious to him than money, you. So in everything you do, give yourself to God, that he may be glorified. And that's today's hidden treasure.